this movie just encapsulates those thoughts that you have, especially at a young age, where it's like, there are so many possibilities here. What if I choose the wrong possibility?
Well, that's, and you know, Max is like, I wish we were just marching off to war, right?
Yeah, because then the choice would be made for you, right? And then it would be like, well, okay, I gotta go to Germany and fight Hitler, you know? And it was horrible. It's terrible. It's this really stupid thing to say, but it's also like the kind of thing you might say when you're 22 years old and you know, kind of privileged and maybe spoiled a little bit.
It really is middle class people problems.
In
a way, I feel like there's a PhD thesis that needs to be written about this, in that these are guys, you know, the whole idea of privilege is talked about more commonly these days. And I think by certain standards of 2019, 2020, that people would say, oh, well, why should we worry about these characters in this movie? And I think maybe at the time some critics said that. And interestingly enough, this movie has like 55% at Rotten Tomatoes. If you go to the Amazon page, a lot of people are like, what's going on with this movie? Nothing happens, you know? So there's people for whom this movie rubbed the wrong way, but it feels like there's this very specific problem of middle classness and the decisions that it places on individuals that Noah Baumbach is still sort of dealing with as an artist.
Yeah, and I think it's specific, like we mentioned, to that time period when, we weren't really at war. I mean, obviously we had the Gulf War, but that was hardly a war. And it just felt like, you know, the economy was generally pretty good. It felt like the world, it was kind of the, you know, post-communism, the world felt like it was at peace. So I think there was more room especially for privileged people to sort of have these moments of, you know, exploration or, just sort of meandering, you know, mental meandering, I guess.
I'm too nostalgic, I'll admit it.
We graduated 4 months ago. What can you possibly be nostalgic for?
I'm nostalgic for conversations I had yesterday. I've begun reminiscing events before they even occur. I'm reminiscing this right now. I can't go to the bar because I've already looked back in it in my memory and I didn't have a good time.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna switch back to briefs.
Obviously the world feels a lot different now. So, you know, I can see that like people who grew up in a different generation, you know, in a different world, might not understand what we were doing in the 90s, just sort of puttering about. But then, you know, you look at like, I look at, you know, this sort of younger generation gravitating toward Friends. And I think there's sort of that same idea there, right? Where it's like, oh, these people were sort of young and privileged and didn't know what they wanted to do with their lives. And I'm sort of envious of that in a way. You know, these younger people, I think, maybe are envious of that, that they had all this idle time, that they could sit in a coffee shop and just talk with each other about things. You know, and Friends is obviously, to me, is a less smart version of Kicking and Screaming, but a lot of the same themes.